Did you know that parallel parking is the leading cause of relationship breakups? Well, that might not be true, but I do know that no female would want to walk in a pouring rain because their man, you know, cannot parallel park in the already existing space in front of their house. So he has to go a quarter of a mile up the block because he cannot put his little putt-putt in that spot. Putt-putt is a car. Parallel parking changed my life. It helped me with hand and eye coordination. The way that your hands and sight work together so that you can do things that require speed and accuracy all in one. I am now on time for a lot of things. If I know that there is a parking spot in front of my destination and there is no meter, I'll park there. I have options now. I don't have to just park in that garage when I know it's gonna take a 10-minute walk to get plugs. I can park in front of building two when it's not metered. Parallel parking and people go together like peas in a pot. You gotta have both together. You can't just have one because you can't parallel park the car without a people in it. I know what people in person is. I just thought it would go together. Yeah, okay. All right. Driver's ed and home training is where it all begins. It starts with practice at home. If your parents can't park, you won't be able to park. So unfortunately, this is being put off on the driver's ed teacher. He can't teach you how to do everything, but he'll try his best. Giving up a parallel parking spot can cause many things. Being late to work, class, appointments, big girl's first elementary school recital and chorus. It makes you have lengthy walks, makes your hot date take a rather lengthy walk, while wearing 6-inch ankle breakers in the rain. Now, what woman would want to go through that? So, you should all learn how to parallel park. And the way you start off, you gotta signal first, because sometimes you'll be coming to parallel park and people will be riding on you. So, signaling to parallel park, you pull 3 feet from the car that you wanna park behind. So if I'm here, 3 feet to my right, and then I beat my brakes 3 times so you see the lights, and then, after I stomp on my brakes, I turn my right turn signal on and put my car in reverse to prepare to back into the spot. Okay. You pull up to the front of the car, red car. Let's imagine this one is not here. Drive around until you find the spot. Okay, you pull up to the front of the car. Sometimes your car is not the same length as the car that you're beside. So if your car is longer than this car, you make sure the back is equivalent. Okay, now you stop. Drive stop, which means not moving at all. You turn your wheel hard to the right. But you really can't turn anymore. Doom. That's the wheel locking in place. Now, you look back and you put your car in reverse. Okay, now you begin backing up slowly, and when you're middle way with the corner bumper car, you see it in your window, you stop. You straighten up your wheel, and after you straighten up your wheel to the middle, which is straight, you back up a little more. And you keep backing up slowly as you're looking back, not because it makes this make you seem like you know what you're doing, but because you need to see. So you keep backing up, and then you stop. You stop that thing right there in motion. Okay. Now, You turn your wheel hard to the left until you hear it stop. Then you back that thing up some more. And as you're backing up, you're swiveling into place. Then you stop. Straighten your wheel back up, middle place. Back up a little bit. Doom. Then you stop. That doom was the brakes and not hitting the car. See that space back there? It even works in chairs. All right. Okay. Now, you parallel park. You can get out your car. Your hot date can get out by the curb. Instead of a quarter mile up the street with the ankle breakers. If you can do these bentacular steps as follows, your car will magically place itself into the correct position, less than 12 inches away from the curb.
This is small.
Typo.
You want to be supposed to like this.
Now, what did you learn? Hopefully not to close your eyes and shimmy backwards, hoping you don't hit the car behind you. But to be your hot date's knight in shining armor, as he or she watches their baby from that window, finesse that wrist on their wheel to get into that parking spot. Welcome to the Cool Kids Club.